on certain terms, subject to certain terms and conditions prescribed under Section 68, the company can buy back its shares. The conditions is that it should be from free reserves, from share premium account. The shares which are to be bought back must be fully paid, and so on and so forth. Buyback amount which is getting involved to buyback should not be 10% of the paid up capital. The buyback should not be more than 10%. The amount involved should not be more than 25% of the paid up capital. There are certain conditions in 68. When you go through 68, you'll find that. Another important aspect is, while issue is being brought, inviting subscription is underwriting contract. There are underwriters in the market. The meaning of underwriter is those who guarantee the subscription to the company. As I said, there's a lot of nervousness when the issue is brought in the market, whether there will be demand for the shares or not. To overcome that, the company enters into a contract with underwriters whose job is to kind of guarantee the company that the shares will be subscribed, and they enter into a contract with the company on a specified charges. That charges are to be paid. That is called underwriter contract. Then another new concept is green shoe concept. Green shoe concept is where the company appoints balancing agents. Once the subscription has come into this issue has come into the market, and the prices of the share is not going up. So how to balance the market? These balancing agents are appointed by the company who purchase share to increase the value of the share. But there is a bar that they cannot purchase more than 15% of the shares, 1/5. And normally what they do is they purchase it from the promoter's quota. And later on, once the price is stabilized in the market, they return that share to the promoter. But they don't pay a kind of profit back to the promoter. Whatever price the promoter's share they have taken, they return refund back to the promoter. That is called green shoe concept. So these are important type of methods when we are talking about shares. Then there is an alteration of share capital also. There can be a possibility of alteration of the share capital. The share capital can be altered by the company in several ways. Like, the company can convert the shares into stock. That is called alteration of the capital. But the conversion of shares into stock can only be done if the shares are fully paid. Fully paid shares only can be converted into stock. Second, the consolidation of the shares. Consolidation means, suppose if the share value is 1 rupee at par value, that can be consolidated to 10 rupee. Opposite to consolidation is subdivision, where 10 rupee par at par value share is divided into 10 shares of 1 rupee each. That is called subdivision. This is also alteration of capital. Share of 10 rupee is subdivided into 1 rupee share of 10 shares. Right? So consolidation, subdivision. Then there is cancellation also. Another way is cancellation. So there are multiple methods where the share capital can be altered. Another way is to increase capital. Sometimes company increases capital, right? Now, moving ahead, this is one area of earning money by subscriptions or into the shares. For doing business, one is capital building, another is taking loans, borrowings. So other than shares is called debentures. You are borrowing money by issuing debentures to the public at large and issuing debenture certificate instead of share certificate. In shares, one gets, shareholder gets dividend if there is a profit into the company. In debentures, the debenture holder gets interest, not the dividend. The only difference is the shareholder's dividend is subject to the profit of the company. But in debentures, the interest is mandatorily to be paid. Like you've taken a loan, interest to dena padega, aapke paas profit hai, loss hai, usko creditor ko us lena dena nahi. Jaise home loan liya, to EMI dena padega. Aapke ghar mein kya pareshani hai, kaun bimar hai, kya hai, usko kuch lena dena nahi. Wo aapko EMI के लिए पहले फोन करेगा, फिर घर में आएगा, कहेगा ये माला, कोई भी परेशानी उसको मुझे. Debentures holder are entitled for interest periodically, right? There are also other kind of borrowing taken from financial institutions, banks. The company can take loan other than debentures. Sometimes company also issues bonds. I'm sorry, somebody asked. कौन बोल रहा है भाई खड़े हो जाइए. हाँ जी बताइए. कोशिश भी मत करना मरने की. पीछे वालों को छोड़ा नहीं जाएगा. Law is not limited to the person's death. Please बेटा खड़े हो जाइए. क्या नाम है आपका? खड़े नहीं हो पा रहे. क्या नाम है आपका?
विशाल.
हाँ विशाल, लोन लेने के बाद जिस जो क्रेडिटर है उसको आपकी डेथ से कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता.
डेथ
इंश्योरेंस भी करते हैं मगर अपने लोन की रिकवरी इंश्योर कर रहे हैं. द सिविल लायबिलिटी डज नॉट एंड विद डेथ. प्लीज अंडरस्टैंड विशाल, व्हाट एंड्स विद डेथ इज ओनली द क्रिमिनल लायबिलिटी. सपोज अ पर्सन हैज कमिटेड अ क्राइम, his successor cannot be punished for that crime after his death. But the, as far as the civil liability is concerned, it does not end with the death. The successors are also liable. आपको अगर हिंदू लो पता हो तो कहते हैं ना पीढ़ियों दर पीढ़ी कर्ज चलता था. So that has not changed. In the modern day world, if you have taken a loan, that liability will not end till the repayment has happened. So the successors are also liable. Otherwise, if the successor does not have that level of income, the property for which it has been taken, that becomes liable. Otherwise, if nothing is there, no property, then you have to get yourself declared insolvent. But even after getting insolvent, your liability does not end. If you want to earn solvency again, you have to keep paying despite from the fresh day after getting insolvent, when you are trying to live, you have to keep paying. So Vishal, loan mat lena beta. Galti se le. Chalo, aage badhte hain. So these are multiple methods of earning money other than share subscription. Now, moving ahead. You have shares, you have debentures, you have money, you've earned, and the business is rolling. But that is not all. Like Once the child is born, he completes his education, gets married, takes loan for a home, gets a job, starts earning salary, but there the woes do not end. Something or other, some trouble keep cropping up. Similarly, the company is incorporated, subscription is there, capital is built up, money is being borrowed, debentures are issued. But in the regular business of the company, there are so many things keep cropping up. And suppose if the company is mismanaged, or there is an allegation that the company is not properly managed, or the company is trying to defraud its creditors or third party, there can be an investigation into the affairs of the company.